the entrance. Actually, it isn't. Well, it is now, but it didn't used to be. The original entrance is actually around the other side, about halfway up. And these stone steps weren't here. The Victorians probably put those in. But that's what happens when something's been here this long. It gets changed, repaired, neglected, captured, seized, ignored, fought for it. It means something different to every generation. But one thing it has meant to everybody, especially the likes of me, is it's a great place to see what's around. Be it the weather coming in, or an army planning to attack. Believe me, there have been plenty of battles down the years. Have you heard of the Battle of Hastings, 1066? Well, when William of Normandy won at Hastings, British land was divided up between his soldiers and retainers. The land around us wasn't known as Clitheroe then. No, it was known as the Blackburn Hundred. And it was given as a gift to a man called Gilbert de Lacy. The Lacy family have been in charge of Clitheroe ever since. It was Gilbert who gave the order to build the keep. Now, there's one big difference between the original castle and the one we see here. It wasn't made of stone. Oh no, it was built using wood. Originally, there were palisades surrounding the keep. Palisades are wooden stakes, and the keep was made of heavy timbers and supported by horizontal beams, which braced or propped up the timbers from within the grounds. Now, here's a surprising fact. The original keep, it came over from Normandy in pieces, like a big jigsaw. It's true. If you don't believe me, look at the Bay of Tapestry. There's one featured in it. Now, why would we put our flat-pack castle right here? Well, look down. You'll see you're standing on a limestone outcrop. The ground is naturally raised, giving that good long view that castles need. Such a raised area is called a motte, and this one is about 120 feet off the valley floor. Perfect! And the limestone is great for foundations on which to build your courtyard or bailey. So this type of castle is called a Motte and Bailey castle. A common type of castle in those days, there were many in Lancashire alone. It wasn't until the mid-1100s that stonemasons converted the castle to stone. If you've not been already, you'll learn all about what it looked like inside the castle when you actually go into the keep. And when you visit the curtain wall, you'll find out about how we got the stone here. Now, I better get back on with my patrol. Keep an eye out for marauding Scots with flaming arrows. And dragons with flaming breath. Yeah. Right. Dragons.